All right. So, let's try that as our first kind of framework for this session. Let me start by asking you a question, Vish. Is that all right?
I have a great question for you.
Okay, you go for it.
What's your favorite mantra?
My favorite mantra. Well, my favorite mantra, that's a good question. If I'm totally honest with you, I know that we grew up in the Hare Krishna movement, and so we sing a lot of Hare Krishna. We sing the Maha Mantra, the Hare Krishna mantra a lot. So in a sense that I understand that the meanings of the Maha Mantra, they're ever expanding, and it like each day I get more from it. In that sense, that's my favorite mantra. But to be honest, I haven't yet fully acquired the taste for the Maha Mantra as truly my favorite mantra. So what happens is my favorite mantra will shift sometimes. I find myself I'll be stuck in a mantra for some time, and I do it a lot, and then all of a sudden a new one will creep in. So even though I chant Maha Mantra every day and in meditation and japa every day, sometimes I have another favorite. The one that I've been sitting on for a while right now is this one that I heard from Akinchana Krishnas Babaji Maharaj recording, which is Govinda Hare Gopala Hare Jai Rama Hare Jai Krishna Hare Jai Prabhu Dinadayala Hare Jai Sachinandana Gaura Hare. Like it has this kind of expanded, but that's I've been just going back and back to that mantra for a long time.
It's like the greatest hits, right? It comes for a while. The hits come for a while. A mantra, it flows for some time, and then you gravitate towards another one, and that other one gets embedded in the heart and the mind. Thank you for sharing that.
So let me ask you a question. How, I know you do a lot of kirtan, but do you practice kirtan? Like, do you actually, will you hear a tune or a melody and then go and sit with it? How do you learn like a new tune?
I have friends that are very analytical about their music study, about their kirtan study, and they listen to a recording and they know where that recording, they can find it and they can re reference back to it and they learn the parts of it. The way it kind of works for me is like it either sticks or it doesn't stick. So like I'm sitting in, I've been in a kirtan with somebody and I hear some melody. It's usually when I was in a kirtan with somebody, and then somehow, like months later or whenever later, I'm doing something, and that melody just kind of like it makes its way to the forefront of my consciousness, and I start to hum it and sing it, and I'm like, where did, I don't even know where I heard it or where I really learned it from, which is not always the best. It's nice to give credit to where you got something from, but I don't always know, and then it'll kind of sizzle in my mind, and I'll start to figure out parts to it, and I will sit with it for a while before, usually before I just, put it out there, and I'll sing it at home, and I'll try to figure out some other parts. But the nice thing about learning it that way, I feel, is that a lot of times, because I memorize the melody from somewhere else, I kind of put my own twist or my own feel to it, which may or may not be correct. But I feel like it becomes mine, and then I'm able to, and then I'm able to, and sometimes I have it a few times, like called up. We have a friend named Amal who like analyzes his tunes, and he knows, oh, so and so sang this on this date.
He's like fantastically talented at all instruments, this kid. And Vish and I grew up with him. He grew up in our kirtans. So he's like he was the little kid who was hanging out in our kirtans when we were younger, And now he's just like incredible, world-class musician.
I'll call him up and be like, what's the third part to this melody? And he'd be like, well, so and so does it this way, and so does it this way. And then so I'll have a little reference. But I do find that sitting with it, especially if I'm playing it on the guitar, I definitely try to figure out ahead of time, because I'm not that accomplished to just do that on the spot. So most of my guitar stuff is not like on the spot. But then again, you know, both of you and I experience on the spot kirtan, right? Where on the spot, you know, where something you're singing a melody and then you just kind of, you figure out another section to it. And sometimes it sticks and you remember it. And then you're like, oh, I can do that thing again. Or sometimes it's like, it's flowed into the offering of the ether and the Ganga has floated away.
Exactly. That little on the spot thing. Let me bring you guys into this kind of private joke. There's this musician who is he's a fantastic kirtan leader, a fantastic musician, but he is a character and a half. He's like five people's worth of characters in one person. And his name is Ajamil. And he comes from, you know, some of the places where the roots of kirtan actually come from, as we understand it. He comes from, Eastern India and, you know, Bangladesh and Bengal, where kirtan really comes from. And we were in a kirtan festival with him one time, and he did this kirtan. And then after, we were all there with him playing drums and cymbals and, you know, kartals and singing or whatever. And then afterwards he said, "You like this tune?" And we said, "Yeah, it was a lovely tune." He said, "This one, on the spot, on the spot." Which means he came up with it right there, you know. Anyway, so now that's become part of the lexicon of all the kirtaniyas. Someone will look at someone else and go, "On the spot, on the spot."
you know what's cool about him is just remembering him. We were just remembering him yesterday and we were laughing because he also does this thing where he says, "This melody, no one can follow. No one can follow." And we're laughing because we're like, but if no one can follow it, how can you do kirtan? Because it's so complicated. He's proud that no one can follow his complex melody.
Yeah, he's such a character. He's so funny. Oh, man. Anyway, Thank you for that nice answer. One of the things I appreciate that you shared on the practical side of music, Vish, is that there are certain instruments that we're more adept at than others. And I don't think that's a limitation to use them in kirtan. So Vish and I think we probably would both say our voice is our most comfortable instrument. You know, and for you, Vish, maybe even your drum is equal to your voice. I don't know, because you're such an accomplished drummer. For me, it goes voice, then harmonium, you know, then, you know, maybe, you know, guitar or flute like that. Flute and guitar, both I'm kind of mediocre at them. Like I can record them so they sound good, but I'm not so good at especially melodic playing on the guitar. But there's still a way to use them. If you're in the kirtan with someone else, you can find a way to play them in the kirtan. So I guess I say that just to highlight the point that sometimes, like a guitar, you're saying you have to sit with it. It's not that you can just pull it out and play in the kirtan. You know, if you know you want to do a guitar for a kirtan, you're saying you have to sit with it before you take that kirtan out and share it with others. I appreciate that.
Totally, especially when it comes to like chord structures, because there's so many nuances in how you could play a chord. One chord could work, one chord could sound better, you know, which chord flows into another one. So there's more sitting with that. I would actually say, you know, it's interesting. I think more comfortable than my voice even is my drumming. I'm actually more comfortable with my drumming. Like when I record, you know, my drums, I usually like one pass and I'm like, that's what it is. And it's good. And when it comes to my voice, I'm like agonizing over, is that good? Did I hit it right? You know? So, in a sense, like when I'm drumming, like, it's like mind off pretty much. And it's so natural. And, I've actually been using this lockdown a little bit to, study my drum again. And I'm studying from my teacher who taught me when I was when I was 11, 12 years old, I studied with a teacher in India, Bublu, and I'm back to, I'm in 4 months now.
He gives classes now. You can still get classes from him, right? I mean, he's available.
He kind of fit me into his schedule. He's teaching 13 hours a day. And so he fit me in after his 13 hours to do classes with me. But yeah, he's an amazing teacher. And, you know, and I'm reconnecting with it now. Like, it's been 25 years that I didn't, like, learn more, study under a teacher for my drumming. And now it's very humbling and revealing, eye-opening.
Beautiful. Thank you. I'm gonna leave another couple minutes here, maybe, you know, 5-ish minutes for Vish and I to kind of just, you know, share. But if you guys want to start thinking of questions, they can be practical questions. They can be very practical. Like, is this the note or is that the note? Or is this the chord or is that? We can try our best to help you with practical questions. And of course, you can unmute yourselves and do that. Or you can share questions in the chat, whatever you're comfortable with. I know Ashley said that she has kids in the background, so she doesn't want to turn the mic on. So, but we're eager to hear and serve you guys and help you guys. So let's see. Let's bring up one other little chat question today, Vish. You have any topics that you want to bring up?
Well, I guess, you know, both you and I, we haven't had too much opportunity to sing in big community. You know, we have our family community, and then we have our little, maybe, you know, kind of little sanghas that we're able to associate with. And what is your experience singing with you know, your
Hi, Bo, Lavi.
This is Lavi. Nice to see you. How old are you, Lavi? I'm gonna say how old you are. You're not six. You're three and a half. We both got haircuts yesterday. Do we look good?
Looking so dapper. Yeah, so it's been interesting.
Yeah, like, this has been our sangha, you know, and what's your experience with your, you know, family kirtans or, you know, just small kirtans?
Well, yeah, we've been doing any kirtan that I've done publicly over the last almost a year now, right? It's been almost a year, like 8-9 months or whatever. Maybe, I mean, I got back from India in February. And we've done a couple of kirtans. We were going each week to the temple during the summer, and we were doing outside kirtans, like social distance with masks on. And we did a few, Osea was there. We did a few of these down in DC, like public outdoor kirtans where there'd be like 6 feet between pods of people. But other than that, a handful of things, it's just been my family. So I've been, my son has been learning drums from Vish on Skype. And that's been really wonderful to watch him blossom as a drummer. I mean, he's already a better drummer than I am. And I've been drumming since I was, you know, whatever, 5. But I never had Vish as a teacher. So anyway, he's doing great. My daughters are singing. They've both learned how to play harmonium in a more comfortable way. I've been watching my kids over this year really blossom, learning harmonium, learning singing, learning rhythm. That's been really great. I do miss it. I've realized, I was thinking about it this morning, that a huge part of who I am is fed by the regular practice that I had of just knowing that this month I'm going to be out somewhere singing with people, sitting with people, singing with people, chanting with people. And unless I make that a habit, the only practice I have is my daily japa practice, which is not the same. And so I've been really missing it. One of our friends, Mukunda, who's also a wonderful young Kirtaniya, you know Mukunda from Chicago, Vish? Mukunda said, man, how great is it going to be when we all get together again and sing? Like, he's just like already waiting for that time. How about for you?
I mean, towards the, you know, I came back from La Vie. I came back from also from India in March, and, you know, was doing so much kirtan there. And when it all went, when, I mean, we kind of came back and immediately kind of just like went into our bubble. But I feel my dad, you know, we lived down the road from my father. And so he was like, Vish, let's get together. And so, you know, for months and months, it was just pretty much him and I. And if other family wanted to join in, they did. But we would just do the sit down. And my father, like, he has his, like, you know, his like five or six tunes that he, that, you know, he's, that, that he sings. And so we would just kind of churn these tunes. And it was really, I felt like really, it was bonding. It was really special bonding. And I missed him because then he went to India in October, November, and got sick there. And now he's back and he's doing okay. But, you know, he did get the Rona, and you know, and I missed him. I missed him while he was gone, and we didn't get to sing together. And,
beautiful.
But, you know, but another thing was, you know, this last month was Kartik, and we got to, as a family, kind of every evening we were getting together and singing. And I just felt like, wow, I would love to have this as a continuous practice in our home as before we go to bed. You know, we have little kids. So it's like, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8 minutes, whatever, chant a little bit in our temple room, offer a candle. It was such a nice practice. And I hope to be able to keep that as we're home.
Beautiful. Yeah. Yeah. This has been a really interesting time. So I'm looking at this question. We got a first question here from Millard. What's up, Millard? How are you? You look like you got a halo there with the sun coming in through your... Millard is asking for chords for I Love You. This is one of the few songs that I happen to have actually written out. I really don't know much about chords. I know very, very little, and I figure them out kind of as I go. I know some of the basic chords, but let's see here. I'm gonna try and see if I can copy these and put them in. It's not letting me paste them in here. Maybe it's too long. But I
Love You is such a good, it's such a good song to learn. I mean, the chords are, you know, I mean, if you learn guitar, you know all the chords that are on, you know, that are in that song. And it's such a sweet song to play at any occasion.
Well, thanks. I'm gonna download this and I'm gonna put it into the chat as a file. Hopefully it'll show up that way. And I'll share it that way. And if you have any more questions about that, Millard, afterwards, we can talk about it again. We have another question here. Feel free to unmute yourselves if you'd like. Gopis saying hello. So let's see. The first question we have here is from Narda. Narda is saying, Hari Om, greetings from Yogaville. Can you please share your favorite tals that you commonly use for kirtan? We have no drummers here, so I use iTabla a lot. What do you think about that, Vish?
So on iTabla, I think that the tals that you would use would be one of our favorite tals that I know that we like to use is bhajani. So there's a tal on there called bhajani, and bhajani, it's got this nice groove. You know, if you want to do it slow, ding, ding, knock, ding. It's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 1. So it's just a good 4-4 timing to use for a lot of kirtans. You can, it also, you can, it's the same rhythm. You can use it slow and speed it up, you know? So it's a really nice, bhajani is used a lot. If you're going a little more kind of classical, there's another 8-8-8 time. It's called Keherwa, and that's a Govinda Jaya Jaya, Gopala Jaya Jaya, Govinda Jaya Jaya, Gopala Jaya, like that. So Keherwa is a nice, another nice one to use. And I know, Gaura, you use iTabla, and you have this system, right, where, like, to do speed ups and stuff.
Yeah, I use I think I use Tintal for a lot of stuff, because Tintal has a backbeat. Can you put on Tintal for a second there, Vish?
I'll speed it up a little bit.
I find this beat to be one of the most universally like usable beats, and you can keep speeding it up or slowing it down as needed. If you play nice and slow, you can almost double time it to get a bhajani kind of feel too.
So if you Tintal is basically, it's basically 8 and 8. It's a 16 beat. So like Keherwa or bhajani are 8 beat. This is a 16 beat, so it opens up more space, and then you can double time the signal.
You know, can you talk a little bit more about that for a second? This is an interesting thing. Rhythm is I think hard for a lot of people sometimes to wrap their heads around. Let's have a chat a little bit about some basic rhythm things so that people can understand. You know, one thing, and you know, one of the reasons why I want you here on this call, Vish, is that I have like opinions, but you actually have like experience and training about stuff. So sometimes it's helpful for me to share what I think, and then you can kind of frame it, say, well, I understand what you're saying, but maybe more like this. So let me share this idea I have, and you can tell me how far off I am. I have this idea that in Indian music, when they give the beat name, like, so they'll say, you know, this is in 4, or this is in 8, or this is in 16, or even like 14. What they're talking about is the length of the cycle until the beat cycle repeats. So in Western music, it's different because it's a little confusing. In Western music, they'll say this is 3-4, or this is, you know, 4-8, which is talking about the way the number of notes in the beat. But in Indian music, they're talking about a cycle length, which is you could do any number of notes within that cycle length. You want to speak to that a little bit, Vish? Do you understand my kind of question comment?
You're right. I don't even understand the question. You're allowed to break it down.
Okay. Good. Okay, so let's start. So in Indian music, if you say something is in 4, it means 1, 2, 3, 4. So, an example would be Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Each section kind of is like completes a phrase, and it's in 4 beats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, Hare Krishna, 3, 4, Krish, 2, 3, 4, Krish, 2, right? So that, you could say that's in 4. Changing, you could say, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Now, technically, beats that are in the same mathematical divisible 4, 8, 16, 32, or 3, 6, 12, theoretically, you can play around with them. But basically, the difference between what I shared the first time and the second time is the phrase is much longer. So a more accomplished musician might choose a 16-beat cycle to express more variation in the rhythm so that it goes along with the melody better. So instead of boom, da, boom, boom, da, da, boom, da, boom, boom, da, da, that's a 4-beat cycle. 1, 2, 3, 4, one, da, boom, da, boom, boom, da, da, boom, da, boom, boom, da, da, right? Vish, is that correct? That's like a 4-beat cycle. So Teen Tall, the one Vish was talking about, is a 16-beat cycle. So it's like, you know, it goes through the cycle of beats, giving a little variation so that by the time it completes itself, it's done so at the same length as the vocal cycle. So it creates a little more variation and beauty. Vish, make this more clear for us.
Well, yeah. Well, I mean, I love the way you describe things because it actually speaks to, you know, someone who might not be wrapping their head around some like musical theoretical concept, and it's a more of a feel. And rhythm is so much, you know, rhythm is feel. And rhythm is the you know, to build a kirtan. I mean, you can sing the same melody through the whole time. I've been in kirtans where we call that the Prabhupada melody, Hare Krishna, where, you know, we sang that for 2 hours, that melody. But because we use the rhythm to like kind of ride this wave of the mantra and the melody, it creates dynamics. So I think this discussion of rhythm is so great to have in kirtan. So in order to answer this idea of thals or what thal to choose or how to choose a thal for your singing, absolutely what Gaura is right, that the Indian system, it doesn't necessarily, like, it uses these cycles. So 4-4-4-4 is 16. 4 times 4 is 16. So every time it goes around all those 16 beats, it comes around again to the one, right? You can also do 4. You can just do 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, or you can do 8, where you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 1, right? So it's like 2 counts of 2. So Keherwa, which if you look on the iTabla, it says 8 beats. That's going to be 2 counts of 4. So it's going to do a cycle where it's still 4-4 in Western time, but each time it'll do 2 cycles of the 4 before it returns back to the what's called the sum in Indian music, or the you know, the downbeat again. Does that make sense? So then as you get more complex with it, there's 4-4 and 4-4, which makes 16. And each time it cycles around that and it comes back again. Now, even if you don't understand that concept, in kirtan, as a drummer, a lot of times what I'll do is, as when we're doing a slower rhythm, I actually will open up the rhythm cycles more. So this is a really nice thing for any of you that like play cajon or djembe or any type of darbuka, any type of hand or drum set. In kirtan, it's really nice to open up the rhythm cycles when it's slower. So when we're going slower, we're playing either like, you know, 4-4-4-4-16 and coming back to the downbeat. An example, you know.
Yeah, give us an example. Give us an example.
So here's a 16 beat cycle. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 1. So I opened up a cycle of a 16, the pattern that I'm playing is 16 beats long, and every 16 beats, it comes back to the beginning of the pattern. So that's that one. Now, if we're now say the kirtan's cooking up a little bit, right? So it's cooking. So now I want to I don't want to keep playing that long, long cycle because it takes 16 beats to come back to the one. Now we're cooking it, so we want to boil it more. So, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1. So now I've made it an 8-beat cycle. So now every 8 beats, the pattern comes back to the one again. So now it feels a little more like it's moving. There's a groove there. And then finally, usually, you know, then we go into a double time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So now I'm just doing a 4-beat cycle.
And sometimes at that point, the singer is singing in 8 or 16. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. And the beat is now slower than the mantra.
Yeah, you can really play with the melodies over the rhythms. When you understand the rhythm, you can actually play with the melody. So you can either speed up a melody or you can even double slow down a melody while the rhythm is going fast and you're singing, you know, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Finish your thought there, Vish.
Just what the example of that was using a melody where the melody is singing the slower part of it, double slow, but the rhythm is playing double fast underneath it. And if you're aware of that, then you know how to make the melody match in with the rhythm.
Okay, so let's say for a second that let's simplify this conversation so it's most educational for folks who are watching. So say you have a melody that has one part, right? So that we've taken that out of the equation. The multiple parts and rhythms from the vocal side, from the chanting side is out, right? Let's just stay with Maha Mantra for now to keep it simple. So, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Right? So now, taking what Vish said and applying it in a practical way is you could start your kirtan. Now let's say that you either have a iTabla Pro or a Tanpura box that has a tabla, or you have a drummer who knows how to play some basic rhythms. So let's just say that you can get whatever rhythm you want. It's another conversation what to do if you're playing by yourself and you don't have anyone who can drum. But let's say you have at least a machine, because that was part of this conversation, that question that came from you, Narada. So let's just say you have a machine that can give you a beat, or you have a drummer who can play a beat. You can start a kirtan like this. I'll just do it with these things for now. I could also get a drum here. Maybe it's smart to do that. But you could start Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. So that's a slow start. Or you could start like this. People do. It depends on the budget.
What are those things you're playing?
I went for a corona test and they gave me these tongue depressors. I got these in Mumbai, like, I don't know, 5 years, 6 years ago or something. They're Rajasthani kartals. They're just wood. I love how essential and elemental they are, you know? They're just, you know, it's just the sound of wood. You know, so many cultures have an instrument like this, you know? Isn't that incredible? So many cultures are like, you know, like in Latin music, they have the clave, you know? right? It's just the same kind of concept. But Karatala, tell us, what does Karatala mean, Vish?
Kala, in the essence of the word, means rhythm, and kara means hands. So playing rhythm with your hands. Even in Sanskrit, when you say tali means play your clapping. Clap on rhythm, right? Tali.
Nice. So that was a slow start. Hare Krishna, right? So that's a slow start. You could also go like this. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And then your song starts off with a little kick. It's like, you know, you lit the fuse early. And now if you take Vish's point, a next step, let's say you start the kirtan with a fast beat. You know, say you're feeling like the room's a little, people are, maybe you're part of a 24-hour kirtan and people are starting to fall asleep. And you've got the 2 a.m. slot. Sometimes it's not a good idea to start like this. Hare Krishna. But, you know, by the time you get to the end of the mantra, you've lost everybody. Sometimes it's good to start like this. All right, kick it up. All right, here we go. And people are like, wow, 2 a.m., we're rocking here. You know. You're using bhajani or something, like one of those beats that Vish shared. Bhajani, right? Or double time, you know, tintal. And you can even sing slow, like Vish is saying. So you can go like this. One, two, three. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. So you're now doing the same slow singing you would have done, but with the beat twice as fast. And it feels like a new part. It feels like a different vibe. And then where it gets really interesting, and I don't want to overwhelm you guys with too much, you know, just like stuff, but just to take this idea one step further, you can then go like this. Rama, Rama. We're still in the fast beat. Hare, Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare. Now, I didn't change anything in my singing. All we changed is the beat, and now it feels like we've done a new part. Right? Or you can play with the rate of your singing and keep the rhythm the same. You know, you can, that's another thing. If you have a part that has only one tune, one melody. This is a great way to get a second part. Hare, Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. All I did is said the exact same tune twice as fast. And now it seems like, wow, where did you get that new part? You have a new melody for that tune. No, I just sang the regular part twice as fast, my friend. So I think that's a good place to leave that particular subject. I really appreciate you sharing, Vish, like that. It helps to hear the way your mind understands these things. You know, we learn. I'm learning also. I'm just looking at the questions here.
All right, Millard, I have one. I'll ask it verbally.
Okay, hold on 1 second, Gopi. Just Millard, I hope you see I put the chords in there for you. Did you see them? Millard was there and then he left again. Oh, somehow or other my mom got booted. Mom, are you there? All right. Before we go to your question quickly, Gopi, I apologize. I just want to.
No problem.
Yeah, sorry. I want to say one thing just because I might forget. So Vish and I are going to be doing this every month, the second Thursday at noon. And if we need to change somehow or the timing, because you guys all feel that it's better to do it earlier, we can discuss that. The last Thursday of the month, I'm doing with my mom a bhakti and philosophy hang. So we're going to do the same thing that we're doing around music, but we're going to do it around bhakti and philosophy. That's not to say that Vish could do the whole thing by himself, both music and philosophy all by himself. Vish actually has a degree in philosophy. But my mom, I want an opportunity for my mom to connect with all of you and for me to learn from her and for her to share. So the first one for that is going to be December 31st, again at noon. So please mark your calendars. It's the second Thursday and the last Thursday, just to keep it uniform. We'll do like that each time at noon. Okay, so now Gopi, I see you had a question that you put here, but you want to ask this or another question, feel free. This is your
time. No, I'm going to ask the question. So obviously the best part of Kirtan is the collective gathering and singing of musicians, as well as there's the audience of participants. We can't do that on video because the sound doesn't sync, the beats don't sync. So that's not working at all, unless you found a solution where it's possible. But I have not come across anyone who solved that. We're trying to do it here.
I have a couple of things. I did try this and it's tiny bit delayed. So it does make it hard, but there is something called Jamulus. Jamulus, and it is an open source software. You can get it from a site called SoundForce, I think.
Okay.
And it almost works.
Okay. That's good to know. But the second thing is, even when I try to sing from a yoga classes, play the harmonium, etc., the people say it doesn't work very well because the harmonium sound doesn't carry. But I've seen you and your family sit in one room and sorry, I'm trying to kill the phone. One second.
It's hello. Please leave a message.
It's Larry Page, bro. You gotta pick it up.
It's the gods from work, yeah. Okay, it seems to have
They want you to worship them and do kirtan to them, Gopi.
Speaking of which, by the way, Gauravani and his family were kind enough. I work at Google. Gauravani and his family were kind enough to sing kirtan for us during the pandemic via video for International Day of Yoga. We have two kirtans at Google, one by Gaura and one by Janavi Harrison. It's beautiful. And Vish has done it in person on campus. Except back to the second question, but I've seen you all play, like Vish and his family play from the living room, and you play with your children, and the sound seems to carry fine. So clearly you've addressed the issue of harmonium and other wind organ instruments carried through on the microphone via Zoom, etc. So what do you do?
We got turned on to a way of adjusting the settings in Zoom. So that there's two factors. And I love that this practical question, because this is, you know, we're here to serve you guys. So let's dig in. So let me just share my screen with you guys. Is that okay? Let's see, how do I do that? I want to share.
Or is that setting where you say don't optimize for audio, don't optimize for video, or something like that?
Okay, so if you've updated your Zoom, let's see if I can get back to the Zoom full screen. So if you've updated your Zoom recently, you can go into the settings and you go here, and you guys are seeing this, right? Are you guys seeing my screen?
We see.
Yeah, you can't share your Zoom screen.
Wait, are you hearing my speaking?
Yep.
Okay, so you see this where it says audio settings?
No, we've seen some of the screen, Gaurav. It's your cords. You need to go to a different tab.
Your Zoom screen, right. That's what someone was saying. We see your screen.
But like, not my Zoom screen.
No, Zoom doesn't let you share your Zoom setup stuff.
Oh, okay. Interesting. All right. Well, let me do it this way and see. It's funny that they do that. I'll explain it to you guys. I'll try and do a freeze frame here. And see if I can get it into Zoom. Zoom doesn't seem to wanna. I'll just explain it then. So if you go to your audio settings, next to your mute button, you'll see audio settings. There's a little caret menu, and at the bottom is something called audio settings. If you click in audio settings, and you guys might want to do this while we're on the phone together, actually. If you haven't, by the way, Vish, if you haven't updated your Zoom recently, you should update it, because they upgraded their settings. So it's good to update the Zoom. So now if you go into your audio settings, you'll see at the very bottom, you almost have to scroll down from the audio. There's a thing called advanced settings. Do you guys see that? Tell me who's not seeing that right now. At the very bottom, you see advanced settings inside your audio settings. If you have any problems, shout out. Then you go into advanced and you see at the top, it says echo cancellation, show in meeting option for original sound. You see all these things here, right? So these are the settings that I've found work best. Now, if you have the old Zoom, you might see something that says show in meeting option to enable original sound. Who is seeing that? Okay, if you turn that on, it will allow you to have a button at the top of your Zoom screen that says turn on or off original sound. You want original sound on when you are doing music. So if you have an updated Zoom, the settings are slightly different, but what you want to do is you want to disable any of their settings that they have in there, except for echo cancellation, which I think you should just leave on auto. In the new Zoom, there's a thing called high fidelity music mode, which you can turn on, and stereo audio, which you can turn on. So if you do this, Gopi, what it does is it stops Zoom from seeing background music as noise. That's what's going on with you, is it's hearing your harmonium as a distortion. It's thinking that there's some sort of a distortion, and so it's compressing the sound. So what you need to do is, in my meeting right now at the top of the screen here, there's something that says turn off original sound, which means I have my original sound on. So you can leave it on or off. It doesn't really change much if you're in a, you know, regular quiet place. If you're maybe in the middle of a city, you might want it, you know, their original settings if it's real noisy. But basically, I leave my original sound on. I turn it on whenever I need. And then that enables the music to come through. So something like flute, you guys should be able to hear this nicely. Can you hear that? Yeah, so that's a sound that Zoom would have assumed was some sort of distortion, especially if it continues for some time. I hope that helps, Gopi. So Hemalata, I saw that you get kicked out, or did you have to jump off really quickly? I want to make sure that the Zoom is working for everyone. If you're able to come off mute and tell me, that would be great. It looks like we're just past our hour. Vish, you want to sing again a little bit to close us out? You want to take us out on the waves of the holy name?
So another thing about this original sound thing is that even though Gaura and I, we can't necessarily sync the timing of our instrumentation, we could actually still kind of play together if it's a little arrhythmic stuff, you know? Thank you. Krishna.
Krishna. Hare Hare. Hare Ram. Hare Rama. Rama Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Hare Rama.
Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare.
So you guys sing, even though you're on mute, let's all sing loudly. Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare.
Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare
Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare.
Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare
Vish, it's such a pleasure to have this time. Thank you so much. Thank you all for being here. We love you all, and we're so grateful to have this time with all of you. Thank you for your good questions. Haribol Tokoshik, Haribol Elizabeth, and Robert. I saw you a couple of times there with your helmet on. And Hemalata and Sebas, Haribol to you guys. Haribol Sebas! These guys are living on this incredible homemade farm in Argentina, making music and making vegetables. Look at how they have inverted seasons. Look how tan and lovely these guys look. Come on, they look so good. And Tom, you're going with the yogi look here. I love it. It's a very, you look like Jesus a little bit, mixed between Jesus and Santa.
Thank you, I think.
And Haribol, you guys are Radha, and Radha, and tell us, you said your baby's name is Kaya. You guys want to say something to everybody? Want to say hello?
Haribol, thank you so much. Gaura, Vish, thank you so much. This has been wonderful. We're here. Everyone on the farm at Plenitude in Puerto Rico is busy today, but we're here joining from North Carolina on behalf of all Plenitude. This was wonderful. Thank you so much. This is Kaya.
Hey, Kaya.
Hi.
So nice to see you guys.
Rukmini always points out that her granddaughter is Kairava.
That's and right.
So sometimes we jokingly refer to her now as Kairava.
Perfect. Perfect. Well, thank you so much, and we love you guys. Thank you for your patronage and for your encouragement and for your encouragement my mom and for the beautiful community that I've gotten to be part of through you guys. These guys are connected with a beautiful community in Puerto Rico doing eco-farming and education called Plenitude. Fantastic. If you want to go and blow your mind and step off the map and do some incredible save, reach out to those guys, right?
Yeah.
And thank you to My Harmonium. You're welcome. And Gopi, we love you. Thank you for being here. So happy. Please feel free to join, each time we do this. We're keeping this link the same. So as I said, don't share this link without either Vish's invitation or my invitation. But my mom is here, Rukmini, so you guys can keep joining same link. This is going to be the same link also for the 31st for the philosophy. Mr. Moses, so nice to see you under the trees. Are you in South Florida? You look like you're in Florida.
Central Florida.
Central Florida.
Beautiful. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you, brother.
So beautiful.
Friend of mine on here, Patrick. Hey, Moses. My friend Patrick is joining in from Munich, and we've been practicing singing and harmonium together for almost a year now. So, yeah.
Beautiful.
So, Goran Vish, a special thanks to you in the midst of all this, the rhythm of our normal festivals and gatherings are gone. So it's easy to lose in touch, but the two of you have been take an extra effort to somehow keep the community together with the regular things and the weekly thing. So thank you for that extra effort. Even just the middle of the stopping my work and just dropping into this feels very special and juicy. The satsang guys there. So thanks for doing this on a consistent basis, just as a seva, with nothing in exchange. So thank you. We're very grateful.
Thank you. Yeah, Gopi, I see your question. Gopi's asking about Vish also has a Patreon. If you want to support Vish, please join his Patreon. I have a Patreon, as does my mom. And, be part of that practical side of the community. Thank you, Michael. I don't know if I saw your face, but thank you for being here. We're so grateful for you. And Betsy, love you and miss you.
Thank you.
Oh, there's Michael. Hey, what's up? How are you? Thank you for being here.
Great. Thank you. It was great.
Thank you.
And I sent those cords over to Millard.
Oh, great. Fantastic. All right. So happy. And Ashley, okay. Haribol.
Hi, Haribol. We've been busy baking some gingerbread cookies here while we've been listening along, and it's been just lovely. So thank you guys for offering this.
Who's the baker?
We have been baking together. baby. Yeah, we've lost her strawberry baby, so she's calling out to the universe for help finding it. If anyone wants to pray for strawberry baby.
What are we naming you?
Strawberry baby is her name.
Your baby is named Strawberry Baby?
That's her baby's name.
Oh.
Yeah. So thank you though so much. Such a great community that you have, and yeah, we're just so blessed to be a part of it.
So are we. Absolutely. So are we. Thank you. And Kilaya, where are you joining from?
I'm in Long Island, New York.
Awesome. Wonderful.
Haribol,
I saw you singing. I saw you on mute, turning and facing the window and singing to the sky.
Yeah, that was really nice. Beautiful. Thanks for sharing that.
Thank you, brother. All right. And Patrick, a pleasure to be with you and all you guys. And thanks for turning on your video, Kaushik. And we hope to see you guys really soon. Thank you again, Vish. I love you. I'm so grateful for you. What a blessing to be on this planet together at this time.
Brother, I want you to know that I love you.
All right, you guys, we'll see you really soon. Thank you so much for being here. We'll see you December 31st for the first philosophy, Bhakti and Philosophy Hang with my mom, Rukmini. Hari, Hari Bol.
Hari Bol.
Hari Bol. Happy Ekadasi to everyone.
I shall see you, Sikasi.
You fasting, Gaura?
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, boy. All right.
All right, Vish.
Thanks so much for making time. Thank your wife, especially, and the kids and everything for making this work. So grateful.
Love you, Vish. I love you.
I love you too.
I love your mom. Tell your mom I love her.
Okay. All right. I'll let her know.
Okay. Arriba.
Arriba.